In this video, we're going to start to study the use of double integrals in physics. And we're going to start by looking at the mass and the center of mass of an extended object. So the things we're going to look at are called laminas. A lamina is a thin sheet. So imagine that you've got some thin sheet of metal. It's a millimeter thick and it's a meter wide. Well, for those purposes, we can essentially ignore the thickness and treat it as a two-dimensional object. So if you treat it as a two-dimensional object, well, the thickness has something to do with how much mass you have in each little bit of area. And so you have to write down a function which tells you how much mass is there per little bit of area. So if we take a little region over here and we say drill it through and how much mass is in that region, you just take the density times the area of that little box. And now you've got the mass of that little box. So this is our general strategy for bulk quantities. We chop them into pieces. We take our lamina and we cut it horizontally and we cut it vertically. And we say, hey, what's the mass of this little piece? And the mass of that little piece is the density of that little piece times the area of that little piece. Now that's not quite exact because the density isn't constant. So you pick a point, x star, y star, and you use that, use the density as that point as a good estimate for what the density is over the entire little box. And that's why it's approximately rho of x star, y star times delta x, delta y. And then you want the mass of all of the boxes. You have to add them up. And that's a sum. And if you want more accuracy, you have to chop things finer and finer and finer and finer. And when the limit is you chop things finer and finer and finer and finer, is by definition the double integral over the region of the density dA. Great. So that's mass. Now the next thing we want to understand is center of mass. Now the center of mass of an object is the balance point. If you held something at the center of mass, it wouldn't tip to either side. And it's also given by the average position of all the atoms in the mass. Where by average, I mean literally a weighted average. So let's look at a one-dimensional example. So suppose that you had this one-dimensional rod that, let's say it's 3 meters long and it has a 10-kilogram weight at the 1 meter point and a 5-kilogram weight at the 4 meter point. And you say, where does it balance? It's connected by something thin with negligible mass in the middle. Well, to do that, you just take an average. This is at position 1, and that average counts, there are 10 kilograms here, so you give that weight 10. And you give this weight 5. There are 5 kilograms at position 4. 10 times 1 plus 5 times 4 is 30. Divided by the total weight, which is 10 plus 5, 30 over 15 makes 2. So if you put in a fulcrum right there at the point 2, it would balance perfectly. There's 10 kilograms to the left and only 5 to the right, but the 5 to the right is 2 steps to the right, and the 10 to the left is only 1 step to the left. This is, in fact, the center of mass. Okay. In general, if you have a bunch of points, you want to take the weighted average. You average the positions of those points where the weight is, well, the weight. It's the amount of mass that that point has. And divide by the total mass. But now in our lamina, we don't just have a finite number of points. We have a continuous distribution of points. When you have continuous distributions, sums turn into integrals. So if you have this continuous distribution, you say, hey, here's our little box. The mass of this little box is the density times the area. And that's the weight that you assign to this value of x and this value of y. So the center of mass has two coordinates. It has an x coordinate and a y coordinate. And to get the x coordinate, you integrate x times the density and then divide by the total mass. And to get the y coordinate, you integrate y times the density and then divide by the total mass. And of course, the total mass is given by the integral of the density integrated over the region. Okay, So that's the theory. Let's work an example. In our example, we'll take something that's distributed on the unit square, but the density isn't constant. The density is x times y. So the first thing we want to do is we want to figure out what the mass is, and we do that by integrating xy dA. Well, dA is dx dy. We integrate over x. X squared over 2 at 1, 0 gives you a half. Then we integrate over y, get y squared over 4 at 1 and 0, that gives us a quarter. And there's our mass. To figure out the x bar, we have to take the integral of x times the density. Xy is the density, x times the density, dA. And now integral of x squared from 0 to 1 gives us a third. So we integrate y over 3 dy, and that gives us 1 sixth. And likewise, if we integrate the average y value, y times the density, you do that integral and you also get a sixth. So put it together, and the average value of x, in other words, the x position of the center of mass, is a sixth divided by a quarter, which is 2/3. And the y position is a sixth divided by a quarter, which is 2/3. So the center of mass is not in the middle. The center of mass is somewhere around here. Because the density is xy, these points over here are a lot heavier than these points over here. So the center of mass is closer to the upper right-hand corner than it is to the lower left-hand corner.